Hello everyone and welcome back to Veil of Sanity episode 9 part 1. I'm Ross RMD, your host and not your GM as always. I'm joined with Biff.
Hello.
Alex.
Yo.
Philip.
Greetings.
Not Johan this time, he's skipping out this session, and Scott.
What up?
And we're just going to get right cracking on with the recap.
Recap. Okay, last time stuff happened. Last time the crew was faced with a threat of the Xenos kind. It was a few Elder ships had appeared orbiting a maiden world protected by the Elder. They didn't like that we anchored there to repair a ship and not burn and kill some flora and fauna. That never happened. So the Elder didn't like that, and instead of telling us beforehand that that is their planet, they decided to wait till we burn everything and, you know, pick some people off in the dark. And when Claudette noticed that after, I think, 3 or 4 days, it was already too late. And the Elder made their very dashing presence clear with a Psi storm, I think, and a lot of Elder attacking the ground forces and decimating the crew. Claudette was injured in a previous fight, and the Elder gave us an ultimatum of evacuating within the hour, which was, well, hardly possible because not everybody could be evacuated in that time. But the Elder didn't allow reason or any argument to come their way, and the captain was nowhere to be found because this previous session he was kind of sucked into darkness, I believe. So everybody struggled a little bit with the problem. Claudette, the crew, had Octavius and his men run a distraction. They all perished, but Claudette somehow managed to go out there to destroy a webway gate. But just in the moment that Octavius, you know, let out his dying breath, Marius reappeared and somehow managed to convince the Elder with some argumentative force to let us be for now. So everybody retreated to the ship. I don't know how many crew were lost, but it is a very sizable amount. And the med bay was full of people. Marius was also going there and being checked out because I believe all of his skin was removed and put back on in the 3 days he was missing. And a foreign object is found is in his chest. We have not yet discerned what kind of thing it is, right?
He has not.
Yeah. And well, at the same moment where Claudette made her way to the medbay and tried to get some treatment for the critical head wound she had, a robed individual from the Ecclesiarchy made their way to the medbay and announced their presence and a mutiny. Their argument sounded well in the ears of the crew, and Marius also saw no other way as to give in, and both the Eagle and Marius and Claudette were sent to the brig, I think it's called, the prison.
Yep. Yes.
And that's where we stopped. Cornelius okay. Arrested. We do not know what kind of arrest it was. It was a fake arrest or whatever. Arrested Marius and led him to the brig for his own safety or for just taking command. We do not know. Yes.
All right.
And that's where we are right now.
So, what do you guys want to be doing?
So I'm pretty sure the Space Hulk just exploded.
The Space Hulk just entered the warp. It's huge amalgam of ships and asteroids
almost a planetary body in itself. And as it enters the warp, the orc ships in the ship graveyard begin to fuse with the Space Hulk as the energies of the Immaterium bend and twist reality. Are you guys following it, or are you staying out?
I think we should leave.
I mean, aren't we going into the warp anyway? Isn't that intention?
You know, INSC, if you try to enter the warp with the Space Hulk, your ship will likely be drawn into the Space Hulk.
Oh, okay. Yep. Let's go! Haita! Slam your foot down.
Okay, so you're going to have Haita break away from the drawing in of the Immaterium so that you can enter the warp yourself.
I think we wanted to travel outside the system, because I think we're still in it.
You are. You're in the outer reaches of the system, so it's not really that hard. And Haita is more than skilled enough to make her way out of the pull of the Immaterium that the Space Hulk is levying upon your ship.
So do I know how large an effect it would have in the warp? Would it be dangerous to enter the warp even near it in the same system? Should I wait until it's finished, or what would I be aware of?
Why don't you make a Forbidden Lore warp check?
Sure, no problem. Seven.
What do you want to find out?
Is it dangerous to go into the warp from where we are with that there?
It's always dangerous to go into the warp. But no, it shouldn't be intrinsically more dangerous to enter the warp with the Space Hulk there. But it just depends. Space Hulks sort of have a sentience of their own, as far as anybody has been able to tell, because they enter and exit the warp and sort of do what they want without any controlling presence, as far as anybody's been able to find out. So if it's just waiting on the other side of the warp and you come into the warp nearby, while distance and time are subjective, it might be waiting for you on the inside.
I mean, as far as I know, we're not... How long would this, going into the warp thing last?
You mean, how long will it take the
Space Hulk? Yeah, to, do its thing and finish.
It's pretty large, but it's making good time, so probably in the next half an hour to an hour.
Oh, okay, we'll just... Yeah, then we can just wait for it to be finished and wait a day and then let it make sure it's all gone and then travel just to be safe.
There's no way we can wait for that. Time is of the essence. Go now.
Who said that?
There's someone. Is there a ghost on the bridge? Cornelius, did you hear that too?
I think I heard a voice.
Okay, so you're able to wait. Cornelius, INSC, and Claudette, why don't you go ahead and change your name to your new character?
Sure thing.
Thank you.
For a second, I thought you were talking about me and Scott, too, and I was like, wait, we've got new characters?
I made new characters for all of us. You're Tom, the tech guy.
Cornelius, are you on the bridge?
Yep, it was me, Haita, INS and Jack, I do believe.
Yes. Alaric, what do you want to be doing?
I will... So, I think I should... his priority would go to go to the brig and release, have the rock trader released.
Go to the brig and have Marius released?
Yes.
You can try to do that, yeah.
Because I do not have any personal contact yet with the other crew, and with Haita and Cornelius and all that stuff. And in my eyes, the situation is clear, so I will try to invoke my my rank and show the people reason without flavor. Yeah, I can do that, Ross.
Okay, so you show up at the brig. It's being guarded by a detachment of troops. Halt, who goes there?
This is Alaric Valerius Apollinaris. I hear the rogue trader has been imprisoned. What is the meaning of this?
Missionary Apollinaris, I apologize, but you cannot approach the brig. I suggest you find alternate means of traversing through this hallway. You can find a maintenance hatchway that'll lead you around this hallway down the 3 subsection. As for the condition of the rogue trader, it is not our place to say. You can speak with Lord Cornelius or Jack, the first mate, who is given command of the ship.
I see. And he turns around and makes his way there. Yes, now that we're established that. Okay. So I make my way to the bridge to meet the others. Sorry, okay. Alex, you will have to wait for a bit.
You show up on the bridge. Apparently, they're having problems determining whether they should call Cornelius regent or Lord Captain.
Knock on the door, Philip.
Is it not open?
Well, say something as you enter, right? I presume.
I just enter the bridge. Let's see. Where is the new Lord Regent?
You see Jack turn around from his console, where he was deep in conversation with a few different individuals. Missionary Apollinaris, my name is Jack. I'm the first mate of the ship. I've been given temporary command by Lord Marius, who is still in charge overall of the ship, as far as I'm concerned, at least. The upper officer crew is taking command of their respective stations temporarily. I believe we're trying to translate into the warp and head towards Imperial space.
I see. I must talk to the rock trader.
I'm afraid that's not possible, missionary.
How so?
He's under arrest.
And I will give him counsel, and I will assess his character, and I will see if he is fit to further command this ship or not. He is, after all, the rogue trader, the Lord Commander of this ship.
Lord Marius is the Lord Commander of the ship. However, you would have to talk to Lord Cornelius, who I believe spoke with Lord Marius and the Eagle about the conditions of the brig.
Show me to him, then.
Since Lord Captain has been taken prisoner, we cannot rightfully say that he is in command of the ship. It is a confusing and delicate situation.
Where is Lord Cornelius?
You can clearly see him on the other side of the bridge.
Is that Jack speaking, or is that you?
That's me out of character telling you can see Lord Cornelius.
Okay.
He might even be like Jesus floating like a Harrier jet.
Can I float too?
No.
Can I try?
Yeah, sure. It doesn't work.
Okay. So I guess I approach humbly from the ground. Say, Lord Cornelius.
There, another priest. But what brings you to the bridge?
I wish to assess the Lord Captain's state of mind. Cornelius. I feel it is wrong that he was imprisoned.
Cornelius, you would know that Missionary Apollinaris is separate from the command chain of command of the Ecclesiarchy aboard the ship. He is nominally in command of any missionary actions that are undertaken, and second in command under the Eagle when aboard the ship, with the Eagle being in the brig and out of his own chain of command. Missionary Apollinaris is now the primary representative both for missionary efforts, and the soul of the ship has been passed to his charge.
Yeah, those words that I chose were very specifically chosen.
I know, I just want everybody to be on the same page.
What was it you said, Philip?
I said I wish to assess the rogue trader, the Lord Commander. I believe he's wrongly imprisoned.
Charges were laid at the Lord Commander. The least of our concern right now. If you haven't noticed, there's a very large warp signature. Not to mention the Eldar that have told us to leave the system, of which we have still yet to do. So the mutiny for now is quelled because of my actions. Right now, we will have to get out of the system first, then reassess, as you so quaintly put.
On with it then. I've waited a long time. Can wait a bit longer.
Then maybe wait somewhere over there where we're out of the way. Thank you already.
I stay standing where I am, prideful. And I, you know, how when I approach, I was standing, you know, very narrowly, and then I just put one foot to the side and take a very broad stance.
Oh, look, he's already getting in the way.
Yes. Out of character, I'm tempted to mirror that and then just, like, be, like, five times as wide.
That's fine. It's just...
No, just...
Seems like Alaric Valerius Apollinaris might be a prideful man.
Yeah, I have no place for pride. I'd just kind of turn the shoulder and continue discussions with INSA and Aita to get out of system first. Or decide what we're doing.
Okay. Like I said, you guys were able to pilot away from the Space Hulk, and it has gone into the warp, and that warp gate has closed.
It's left the system, and I think it will not be a problem into the warp, even as unlikely as it would have been in any case. We should be able to enter safely. As safe as it can get now.
Well, I propose that for now we continue our course as laid down by Lord Captain until we are safe enough to ascertain the causes of this mutiny and hopefully get the Lord Captain back to his rightful place.
Do you mean continue our course as in exit the system via plasma engines or whatever, not warp engines? Or do you want us to warp to the Imperium?
No, that would have been, make the warp jump that we had planned.
Okay, so to the Imperial space up here, wherever, I can't see anymore.
I'm with you guys, over.
Oh, thank you. You want us to jump to here, right?
Could we make it in one? I thought we had to make it in two, didn't we?
We could do in two, but I think doing in one is... I mean, I don't... We can do in one, two, whatever.
I think we discussed it last week and agreed to do it in one. Because it's no less safe to do it in one.
Basically what I'm saying is we just continue with what was agreed upon last time. What was our previous orders.
Okay.
Make it so.
I see you're enjoying your regency position. Very well, Hayata. Let's get to it. So I would like to use my fancy ritual. So I want to get in my Navigator throne and use my signature ritual to infuse my chamber with psychotropic joystrix, then inspire weird visions within her psyche, which give them clues concerning the ensuing journey. Oh no, that's for divine inauguries, so that doesn't give me a plus 20 to... Yeah, that's plus 20 to Signy Science, right? As a Navigator of House Malaspina adds plus 20 bonus to Signy Science test if he performs a ritual beforehand, however it gives D5 minus 2 corruption points. Yeah?
Okay.
Oh, D5 minus 2. It can be 0, so please be a 2 or 1. It's going to be 5.
Take 3 corruption. What is your corruption threshold right now?
43 now.
What? Jesus.
Yeah.
I flick my flame a little when I see that.
Okay, but then I get a plus 20 on my Signy Science roll. To locate the Astromicon. So, oh no, I wanted to use the Navigator Warp Eye.
Do you want to use the Navigator Warp Eye? Okay.
Hell yeah, I do. So, as it obscure, shrouded, lightless, what modifier would I get to my locating the Navigator Warp Eye?
You're not getting any negatives. You're actually going to get some positives. You're going to get a plus 10 on this.
Okay, so plus 30 in total. And there's no modifier for charts and locating it, no.
Plus 20 from the ship, remember, for navigating.
Oh yeah, but that's for navigating the warp, not for the locating.
Oh, map.
No worries. Whew, nice!
Okay, so you peer into the warp. And then you focus and lock your mind onto the Navigator Warp Eye, the baleful red eye on the warp that is obscuring the light of the Astronomicon. When you do this, it senses your focus, and you feel it lock its gaze on you.
If I could do like a warp nod and hello, or like I would do like, hey, sup? I'm not trying to hide, regardless.
You're not trying to hide. Okay. Well, it's trying to get into your mind. Do you allow it to?
I think you told me last time this would damage me if it got my mind, right?
I'm not sure what we were talking about.
Would this damage me if it got in my mind? Because I think I wanted to say I'd let it go in my mind, and then you told me if I did that would hurt.
Yeah, it probably will hurt.
But like permanent damage? Probably, right?
That depends. You're quite far away from it right now. You're going to either have to... Right now, you need to just make a decision. I can't tell you what the outcomes will be.
Okay, well, I like the nav thing, so I'm gonna lay down like my first defensive wall if it wants to examine my mind, but I'm gonna have like backups if it starts like searing through. You get what I'm saying? Like, I imagine it's more like a fortress with a many walled layer than, because like, especially how psychic powers work, you don't instantly get access to all their mind. There's like a surface level and then a subconscious and stuff like that. So I want to like open up my surface level.
You open up your surface level. Okay. Go ahead and make a willpower test and make this at a negative 20. If you can say that this is a psychic power for terms of resistance.
Oh, so I'd actually get 3.2 degrees of success then.
Okay.
Oh, 4.2, because I'm resistant to psychic powers as well.
Alright.
feel it enter your mind and take hold of what you allow it to take hold. It sears a hateful, malign, runic presence into your surface thoughts. And you can feel some of your memories boil away as it consumes them.
Okay, I'm going to try and... I'm like, nope! No, I need those! I'm like, shut off then.
Roll 1d10 plus 3.
Please don't be corruption.
It is.
Get rolling. I think
I'm on 52 55. Corruption. 55, yep.
Rip Ross.
Rip the crew.
You do not take any insanity, nor are you fearful due to your willpower roll.
Great.
Okay, yeah, we'll do a malignancy test. That's just a willpower test. Okay.
Has he got to the point where he gets minuses?
I believe he has.
55 corruption.
Musical timing.
My guard is going to be retired before I even get to play. He's going to get that 100 corruption or whatever. What page is corruption? I'm gonna forget.
Two, 295 onwards.
Thank you. 295.
I'm sorry. You're not at 60, so you're not debased. You do take a negative 10 on this malignancy test.
Okay, minus 10. Succeeded.
For every 10 corruption points the character gains, he must taps. Okay, and you succeeded.
In 60, I'll have to get another mutation, right? And I suck at toughness rolls, so I'm definitely going to get one. Oh no, it's the mutation is the two random characteristics, right?
You'll get a mutation, but so far you've yet to get a bad one.
There are basically no bad ones in the nav ones. I would say my claws are pretty bad. Not that they do anything.
Okay.
Okay, so back to piling the... Or is he still ravaging me, or can I go back to piling?
No, you're good.
Sweet. So... minus 60 for Uncharted, plus 60 for my Siny Science roll, plus 20 for the Runecaster on the ship. Right?
Yep.
Yeah.
Okay. So that's 1, so that's doubled to 2. Oh, and that, wait, is Navigation Warp Intelligence? So I would get my Natural Intelligence on this, right?
Only unopposed.
Yeah, it's not an opposed check.
Yep, you're right.
Okay, so... you got 2 successes. Alright.
Let's keep rolling.
Yeah.
12.
And you make it to the system.
Easy.
Yes, quite easy. You burst out of the warp.
Oh, by the way, your tokens still got huge circles, so you reveal a bunch of stuff.
That's alright.
Okay.
Okay, roll 1d100 plus 20.
106.
Make a navigation stellar check.
Any modifiers?
No. Now roll 3d10. Take 8 days to get to the inner cauldron from where you've come out of the warp. Roll 2d10.
18.
And now roll 1d100 plus 40.
69.
Okay, you were in the warp for 6 days. Or the number of days that have passed real time, 6, and you were in the warp for 1 day.
Nice.
Great. I totally forgot to use my foreshadowing. Silly me.
That's alright.
Oh, can I try and chart it?
Yeah, you can.
So just a straight trade astro. I'm going to foreshadow. I'm a trade astrographer. Roll. I'll just take the plus 10. I won't bother with the rolling a bunch of times.
What does foreshadowing do?
You pull, it's, I can copy paste it for you if you want. It's the plus 10%, and then you can take another secret from the future. You bring secrets in from the future to give you.
No, you're doing this in the. This has already happened, so okay. There's no foreshadowing.
There you go.
Okay. Yeah, you're easily able to chart that route.
I did it! I found out that Malspina routes have a bunch of charted routes automatically, Malspina, but they're in the Kronos Expanse, so they're totally useless here.
You would say that you have good charts for that route.
Sweet.
All right. You have arrived in a system that has a blue dwarf. What do you guys want to do?
Ogres.
Sure.
You got scrutiny, Scott?
Yep, still not trying it.
Okay, I've got it. Can we get Hiata to help? I can aid Hiata? Or do you want me to do it?
Ohio will not make any rolls.
Okay. Well, I've only got 15 scrutiny. Can I foreshadow that?
If only someone else is on the bridge that had scrutiny.
I don't have it.
Who are you talking about, Alex?
No one in particular.
I don't know. Okay. I guess that's good. Plus our ships.
Would I be able to assist with this?
Yeah, you can assist with it if you have scrutiny trained.
Sorry, what was that? Let me just open up the wee frigate thing. I forgot to open that. My bad.
It's 25.
25, okay.
And you get a plus 10 from Haida.
Oh, I forgot to plus 10, so 5.8.
And Cornelius, were you assisting?
He can't.
No, not going to trend.
Okay. So 5.8 degrees of success.
Yep.
But there is one planet in the system. There are no other celestial bodies besides the blue dwarf in this one planet. There are no asteroid fields. There are no gravitic rifts. There is nothing but a single planet and a single star and a single ship of Imperial design, which is in orbit above the planet.
What type of, what class of ship?
You don't know.
We're here, Cornelius. Jack?
You can make a lore war?
Imperial Navy?
Or Imperial Navy?
Imperial Navy.
All of us or just Ionesi?
Anybody who wants to know what that ship is.
No modifiers?
No, no modifiers. Okay. INSE. That is an Imperial Destroyer. It's not a very common ship.
Okay.
In fact, the Imperial Navy hardly ever uses them. But there are rumors that the Inquisition and some Adeptus Astartes use Imperial Destroyers. It's a smaller ship. Smaller than your Raider, in fact. It has a very compact crew requirement, but it is loaded with weapons and armor. It's a dangerous ship of singular purpose.
So I guess its purpose is to destroy.
I mean, that's what the name would suggest, Scott.
Well, I'm going to inform...
Oh, I thought it was to purge. Oh.
Here, do I know the name of the ship? If it's Inquisition, would I have forbidden Lord Inquisition to know it?
You're not close enough to read what the name is, okay. And you're not getting an IFF signal from this far out.
Sweet. Well, Lord Regents and other members of the ship, we have arrived at the Imperial space. There is a Imperial Destroyer circling the single planet and a blue dwarf, as you can see outside. Orders for Hayata, not me, I'm done putting my feet up.
Well, I believe our priority is to make sure we are not aggressive.
Yes, I believe we have no warrant to be in this space, and that ship could, it's packing a punch. As small as it looks.
I believe if this was an Inquisition vessel, they would show no mercy.
Yes, thank you for stating the obvious. Jack, we should probably hail this ship.
Very good, Lord Cornelius. Comms. Hail the ship. Comms turns, looking a little consternated. Sir, we've been monitoring traffic since we came into the system. We sent out a ping for the IFF, but we got nothing in return. Literally, our ping did not return.
Would I know of any tech that could mask signals?
Yeah, go ahead and make me a Forbidden Lore Archaeotech test.
Fantastic. God damn it.
Do you want to fate that?
Yeah, I guess this is like one of my only opportunities to actually do anything since Ross has got it all covered. yeah, I'll fate that.
Yes, I do have it all covered traveling in the warp. I would hope so. Why don't you use your foresight or whatever to get a nice roll?
Okay. Got a 5. Very nice. There are several different technologies that could affect that. But what you're seeing here, you're pretty certain, is an albative covering on the ship. Based on your own detection values, and you're seeing that the signal is being jammed in return. So it's going, the ping is going out, but the information is not bouncing off of its IFF dish or indeed the ship itself. So It's sort of like an informational black hole. These are usually blockade runners. If they want to get in somewhere undetected and get out, likely, since it's the only ship in the system and there's no other foreign contaminants in space, that's the only reason you detected it so easily.
Okay, I suppose I'll relay that information to Jack. Jack,
you would know that this is almost predominantly exploratory tech and Inquisition tech.
How very interesting. The signal has been jammed by some very old and rare technology. There's very few people that own this particular kind of technology.
So they're ignoring our messages and jamming the signal. This seems like a fantastic start to our venture in Imperial space.
You notice that the ship has started moving on your scopes in your direction.
Well, I believe they wish to make contact.
With fire? Question mark.
Keep hailing the ship, make sure they're aware of our peaceful intentions.
Okay, so you're gonna stay in your throne, and ready to jump.
I'm gonna lock the door in my throne, like close it up. I'm not gonna go all put the column all the way up, but I'm gonna close it so that, you know, if they're unpicked with us or anything like that, they don't see me.
Okay, so you would have to go all the way up so that nobody could see you.
Would I still be able to communicate with the bridge? Would I have like an open vox line with the bridge if I went all the way up?
You could have an open vox line.
Sweet, yes. I'll do that, yeah. I don't want them to, in case it's an Inquisitor who's hunting me or something. She's paranoid, so it makes sense that she would do this.
Jack comes up to you, Cornelius. What do you know about this ship, Lord Cornelius?
Would I know everything that you told us out of character about the ship?
What I told INSE about it?
I don't know how. Did you say what you'd relayed about that, Ross? Or?
Yeah, I told you that. Yeah, I did. I told you it was rigged to, like, it was packing a punch and likely Inquisition.
Other than the fact that it has some extremely rare technology and a lot of firepower, nothing.
Well, we're here to make contact with the Imperium, so there's no point in taking an aggressive approach.
And I think it'd be futile if we did.
You don't think this is pirates?
Varus would not have access to its technology. Unless they were very, very, very powerful.
Very good. I'm going to relay some orders to have the gun crews stand down and power down our weapon systems. This should put us on a negotiating stance. They should read this on their sensors.
Jewish, that makes sense.
Should the Inquisition not be able to hear us just from where they are?
We know not that it is the Inquisition.
But yes, they... most ships would be able to make a hail. If we can hail them, they'd be able to hail us.
They've just chosen not to.
Yeah.
Yes, missionary.
Just out of character real quick, it is not relayed that this might be an Inquisition vessel, right?
I told Cornelius out loud that this is Imperial Destroyer, most likely Inquisition, and...
Can I roll Forbidden Law Inquisition?
Absolutely.
Right. Well, I asked to roll that and you said no!
When did I say no to Forbidden Lore Inquisition?
I said, can I roll Forbidden Lore Inquisition?
That was before you made the whole spotting checks. Biff said you cannot see that yet.
Ross, you specifically asked to figure out what the name of the ship.
Oh.
So, you want to roll Forbidden Lore? Anybody who wants to roll Forbidden Lore Inquisition may. Absolutely. It's going to be a negative 20.
Oh, well, I'm already at 20.
Plus 10, actually, for the information you've uncovered so far. So it's only a negative 10.
Okay, mine's been 0.2 degrees of success.
Do you want to re-roll that, anybody?
I will try my luck. Minus 10, yes?
Minus 10.
Nope.
It says you're taking a minus 15.
I'm from an Imperial world, so I get minus 5 to all Forbidden Law tests.
Oh. Okay. Ionesi. You know a little about what you think is approaching. There have been rumors of an Adeptus Astartes attachment to the Ordo Xenos called the Death Watch. You think this might be a Death Watch ship?
Okay, I'll say
they're an extremely secretive organization.
Okay. Then I won't. I'll keep that. I'll say. So Astartes are not secretive, but Death Watch is, right?
Why don't you tell me what you mean by that?
So if I said there may be Space Marines, that's a lot different from saying there may be Death Watch.
Death Watch is comprised. You don't know enough about Death Watch for me to give you that information.
Yeah. Okay, well then I would just say it's a sect of Space Marines called Death Watch. If I didn't know that Death Watch were more less known than just regular Space Marines, then I would just say that.
Now, you did pass your check with a degree of success, or 0.8. So if there's a question you wanted to ask, go ahead and ask it.
Okay. I will ask. I'm gonna ask a very specific question to my background, because fuck everyone else. My question is, what are Space Marine of the first and second founding? Because these people do not work with my house, and they hate me.
Well, the first and second founding Space Marines?
Yeah.
Space Marines in general aren't common, so... it's difficult for me to answer how common. So it just depends what section of space you're in, the types of Marines that you might come across. Everybody would know that different chapters oversee different areas. You guys are in the Segmentum Ultimus.
Mm-hmm.
So everybody would know that at least the Ultramarines are active in this area, which are first founding.
Okay, so I didn't really know what first and second founding were. So that's like all the different chapters then.
The first founding chapter. Can I explain?
Go ahead.
Yeah. So the first founding chapters were the original chapters: Ultramarines, Imperial Fists,
Imperial Fists, etc., Blood Angels,
Space
Wolves, so Dark Angels.
All of what were the legions, and then the second founding are the
successor chapters.
Yeah, the successor chapters that offshoot from the original chapter.
So basically, first and second founding, Ross, is almost all of them.
It's not. There's 23 foundings, so there's a lot of different Space Marine chapters, but the first and second foundings are pretty prevalent.
Okay, the well-known ones, anyway.
Yeah, all the ones I would have heard
part
before.
Of them are probably first or second.
Oh,
founding.
I see,
because
okay.
They're the ones that have been around the longest.
That is true.
It says that even members of my house don't know why the Space Marines hate us. So I'm curious. I guess we might find that out. But yeah, well, I'll tell them that there may be Space Marines on that vessel. From what I recall, Space Marines are quite common on this vessel, or something along that lines.
Space Marines are common on the vessel.
Inquisitional vessels of this nature. This seems like a Space Marine type. It could be a Space Marine type escapade. Just
so
a little.
Getting a hail. You're getting a hail on the comm system.
Bring the communications up.
Imperial vessel, Invictus. This is the requisite hate. You are in violation of your treaty. Your warrant of trade is not one that is cataloged to be in the Jericho Reach. In addition, this is a forbidden system. Heave to or be destroyed.
Can I find out what I know about the requisite hate?
You would not know anything.
Okay.
Unless you have Jericho Reach lore.
Nope.
Inessi, are we ready to make another jump? I don't fancy tangling.
I can make an emergency work. Did we travel the 8 days into system, I presume, or are we still at the outer edge?
I'm sorry?
We spawned 8 days out of the inner cauldron?
The inner system. Yeah. Yes, you guys are in the outer reaches.
Okay, just confirming.
Also where the singular planet is at.
Okay, my bad. Right, so we didn't even travel. So I said, yes, I can always make an emergency warp jump. It's more dangerous the less time I have to take it. But if the warp is as calm as it was moments ago, which it may not be... we should be okay. I can return us to where we were.
I'm sorry, we're talking about running? I thought we were coming to Imperial Space for a reason.
We're definitely coming to Imperial Space for a reason, however, if this is a restricted Imperial Space, of which we're not supposed to be here anyway...
What does
they've already cataloged the name of our ship.
Jack, what does the Inquisition do to people who know forbidden things? We may be a problem if we stay. I can understand where Cornelius is coming from.
We'll have a problem if we leave. This is madness. They already know our ship. They know that we're a rogue trader. What do you propose that we do? We fly into Imperial space where they'll somehow not know us?
The galaxy is a wide place. But Cornelius, I bow to his authority.
I will do what you say, but I have a log of complaint. I do not think that we should leave.
I simply wish to maintain the life of the ship and the crew. If they offer a chance to escape destruction, I think we should take it.
I am merely at the ready, Jack. It does not mean we'll go for it.
Yes, yes. I was not simply saying we run, turn tail and run. Just we need to be prepared.
Should worst comes to worst, since Cornelius has got great fellowship, bros.
So you want us to heave too?
I believe at the very least we should cease our forward progress. I may be acting in regent of the Lord Captain, however, you are still the second in command, Jack.
Should we speak to the Lord Captain about this?
It is his ship, and I suppose currently we were not operating correctly without him. And hence the reason why we need to get to Imperial Space to sort out this mess.
You could tell the Inquisition we'll go to other Imperial Space. If you know of any nearby.
Possibly parlay for a stay, of course. At least get a few days in system.
At the very least, I think we should communicate with them before they start blasting. They're not known to be patient.
Haida, bring the engines offline and cease our forward movement. Who wants to speak to them?
I think it would be unwise for me to speak as captain of the ship. That would raise more questions than it answers. And I don't know who this person is.
Missionary Apollinaris.
Yes.
By all means, sir.
Out of character, guys, I do not know what to say, but my character is good at talking, which none of you are. So I believe
I'm good at talking. Fuck you.
Except, are you?
Yeah, but I don't want to speak to the Inquisition. They hate me.
See? Okay, so I mean, we could just
keep on, you're not coming across the comms. Forever, but I'm the Lord Engine, sir, taking command of this ship.
So, I mean, what do we do?
What was your end character? What your end character saying? I should be the one to speak to the Inquisition.
Honestly, I have no idea what we're doing here. Just saying.
So, our character, we made the jump in system to get away A, from the Eldar, and B, to hold up and sort out the mutiny, as it were.
Yeah, I thought we were trying to find the judge.
We're not doing anything of the sort to sort of the mutiny.
I thought we were taking the Marius to court. That's what I thought we were doing.
Yeah, well, that's what I mean. We're heading to Imperial Space to resolve that.
But, I mean, I think we should resolve it inside the ship. We are basically like another entity.
Yes,
but on the fringes, usually, anyways.
As a character, you've not made that clear. We're operating off of what's happened previously to your character being introduced.
Yeah, I guess.
If you want to tell us we shouldn't have gone, you might have said that before the warp jump.
Well, Cornelius shushed me and I don't
yeah,
know.
Yeah, yeah, you're right.
I mean, you still need to take into account that I'm a total newbie in 40k, so sometimes I think we should implement more out-of-character chatter for this kind of stuff, because I cannot do this in-character most of the time.
Okay.
What do you mean? You want to just have more conversation about what's going on?
No, but when I want...
I think what Philip's trying to say is that his lack of knowledge about the system and the fluff and the lore about the 40k universe impacts his decisions that he makes as a character. So he'd prefer to have a chat about what he would know, what he wouldn't know, out of character to make
sensible proper decisions.
Yeah.
So,
okay, we can do that. What do you want to know?
So I want to know, as in Jack, who said, for example, I as a player character was really confused by Jack saying that he wants to stay, when we were clearly got two options, either perish and die or just go on.
Okay, so first, they said heave to or be destroyed. They didn't say heave to and be destroyed.
Oh, heave to as in stop moving.
Yes. Heave to normally is what you tell people before you board them. But I don't know if they're okay. intending to board
this. That's an it's an English thing. I missed that.
My bad. So they're threatening to destroy you if you try to leave.
Oh yeah,
Jack then we will stay. Doesn't want to leave because when they hailed the ship, they not only said the name of the ship, they know that you're a rogue trader.
Yeah.
That probably means that they know who you are. So if you leave, yeah, you'll go somewhere else. Mm-hmm. But if they have an astropath on board, those people that you go to, if they're Imperial citizens, especially if they're the Inquisition, since you guys think this is an Inquisition ship, they'll know that you ran from the Inquisition.
Okay, I got it now.
It's guilt.
Okay.
Yeah, now our character decision that Cornelius was made was just to be prepared.
Cornelius would rather run than die, basically.
I understood that now. How long till they reach us? Do we know that? Or is that a question
I should ask? Seems like a pretty fast ship. They're coming up on you pretty quickly. It'd probably take like an hour before they're abreast of you.
So, I turn to the people. Oh, you want us? Will you join us? Sorry for.
I'm sorry. What?
I'll be home in about 45 minutes. So probably not.
So just okay. Keep going.
Yeah, yeah. So I turn to Cornelius and Jack and Ionis, and I say, "How long till they arrive? Clearly, there's something, a lot of." Things that must be cleared up before they arrive.
I think we have roughly an hour.
What are we to do about the rogue trader?
Well, the current situation, you do not know it anyway, however, the current situation is that there was a mutiny created, trusted the captain was betrayed. A sticky situation happened, and I defused that by incarcerating both the Eagle and the Captain for the moment. I'm of the thought that the Captain is innocent. He simply acted as he saw best. However, the situation is delicate. I think for now, it's a problem that the Captain is in the brig.
Shall we not get him out of there?
We don't want the crew to mutiny again, was the worry. But yeah, it would be helpful.
Out of character, last time, who was it that gave the great speech?
Me.
Ionesi, right?
Yeah, you would have heard that, I guess, because it was Fox all the ship.
So, did you not appease the crew? Or
I don't know how appeased they are, though. Like, that's the thing. Who knows if it's a powder keg?
Critical.
Yeah, but in character, it's not like we've gone around and asked the crew, would you riot if the rogue trader was released? I mean, yeah, we could try and release him and hope that doesn't inflame the crew enough, because I did so well and attempt to calm them some more if they do get inflamed. And it may be the correct decision to do.
I think we should definitely... I can go back into character. I believe the rogue trader, as the owner of the ship and the rightful Lord Captain, should be released to parley.
I would be under the inclination to agree, were it not the Inquisition. The charges that have been laid against the Captain are dangerous charges.
Yes, you all know that heresy has been laid at his feet, and the Eagle made pretty good evidence of these charges.
Also, the Captain has a Xenos deck inside his chest. Might be best to keep him hidden.
If you free the Captain, you, at the very minimum, would know that you're basically saying that these charges don't matter.
Yeah, that's the point that Connie's trying to make, that we incriminate ourselves by doing so. I think for the moment we know that the captain has made some ill-informed decisions. Things have happened. We can't deny that. For now, we're trying to do the best with a terrible situation. I think we just have to throw ourselves at the mercy of the Inquisition for now. It's not our choice.
Now, Vras.
Hi.
Or, I'm sorry.
I forgive you.
Alaric.
Yes.
If you don't agree with what the Eagle has done, if you think that the things that the Eagle has said are untrue, you are technically the reigning ecclesiarchy priest aboard right now, since the Eagle's been taken into custody. He has ceded his authority. If you want to try and turn the crew against the Eagle, you could, but you know that that won't be easy. And it won't be quick.
Yeah, it's not a thing of an hour. No, the initial thought was because there were times of like 8 days and all that jazz, I misunderstood. I thought we were very far away from the ship. So I thought we maybe had a week to purge all the people that know too much and get on with it or something.
You could still try to do that.
Could I speak to the crew of the ship
and
basically denounce the Eagle and what he has done?
Yeah, you can do that.
Because I'm a people person. Well, my character is anyway.
You would at a minimum know that the Eagle has evidence of his charges.
Yes, but the Eagle also hasn't revealed all that he is. Because
I don't think you know any of the bad things about the Eagle, though, do you?
Would I not? Because
probably not. You've been sequestered yourself.
Yeah, I guess.
The things you've found out is just you coming out of your isolation.
I think me and Haita are probably the only ones that know anything about the Eagle that's incriminating.
Should have wrote your backstory, Philip, that you were a second-hand man, and now you've turned against them. Because he went too far.
Well, maybe I should have. Maybe I should have wrote my backstory that I'm the all-knowing entity of the universe, and that would be that.
Yeah, it's a bit metagame, isn't
it? Yeah, I was joking.
Yeah. I am the Eagle's son!
And the Falcon!
nice. So, our problem right now is time. The biggest problem. I shall be of assistance, but I do not know how to assess the situation. I believe my initial thoughts were a bit ungrounded and immature.
And naive.
That was too much. I challenge you to a duel.
I have a problem that if we inform the Inquisition that we have claimed heretical rogue trader on board who is in this place with no warrant and who commanded us to go to this forbidden planet, it may not come across well. I'm not sure how we're going to contact them without a rogue trader, without also informing them that a rogue trader is in such a position, especially since, unless they learn of me, I have no doubt they want to come aboard.
What do you mean by that?
Well, the Inquisitors are going to want to search our ship. It's out of question.
You said if they learn about me?
Oh, if the Space Marines, they have a... Me and the Space Marines in my house, we have a long-standing... It's a long story. It's unlikely they'll come aboard in that scenario.
It's probably because of the way you look.
What did you just say to me? I'll have you know I graduated top 500 in my navigator class.
in a class of 501.
Thanks, Alex. I knew I'd said it wrong. Not 500. Wow, well done you.
So what have you guys decided to do?
I believe we haven't decided anything yet.
ignore their heal, apparently, is what we're doing.
Well, you have heave too. Jack ordered it and Hyatt has complied.
Yeah, we'll just not reply back to say, yes, please enter us.
We can push all the blame on Hyena.
Oh wait, they'll see my flag at the top of the ship, so they probably already know there's a house Malaspina here.
That seems likely.
So phew, no space marine getting on board this ship, guys. They just refuse
to,
apparently.
There's at least one badass enough to board the ship regardless.
I don't know, did you read that? Nor do they ever! Ooh!
So, are we saying that we should release the captain for now? Is that what your suggestion is?
Can we give him a Vox while he's in prison? This would not offend the crew, and it would allow him to communicate.
Well, I can get him on the Vox now, I assume. I'm sure the jailer would be more than compliant.
That seems like a good middle ground. The crew doesn't have to know that he's communicating. I kind of look around I don't look around because I'm inside my... Actually, I would be inside then, since he obviously can tell from the flag on top of the ship, so there's no reason to sequester myself inside my throne. So I look suspiciously around the bridge, because it's probably like people will leak this information out.
So I'd get the jailer on Vox.
Alright.
I'm trying to find his name, but I can't find my notes.
Fortius,
that's it. Jailer Fortius, this is Lord Cornelius.
He picks up, and you hear the sounds of Claudette being tortured. What is it?
A moment of your time, please.
What did you say?
A moment of your time, please. Please cease torturing the Xenos. I think we have enough of that sentiment on the ship already.
She was getting a little mouthy.
How about the other prisoners? Are they talkative?
There's only one other prisoner in here.
Ego and Marius, right?
What do you mean?
Oh, yes, well, of course. Maybe there's two other prisoners in here.
Which is it, man, damn it?
Well, I can't be expected to keep track of all these people.
That is literally your job.
Is he an imbecile?
Marius.
Yes.
You see that in the midst of Fortius using the cattle prod on Claudette, he takes a call. He seems upset by this call. He stops talking to them, and he comes over to you, and he hands you the box.
I take the box from him.
Well, Captain, this is Lord Cornelius.
Ah, Cornelius, you've decided to speak with me at last.
Speak with you, rather than let you dig yourself into a hole you can't get yourself out of?
The digging was over, my friend.
I simply sought to defuse the situation.
Well, it's a high time you get me out of here. You know my opinion of being caged.
Quite. Temporary measures and all that. However, we have pressing concerns. Seek your advice for now. We wish not to anger the crew further.
Very well. What have we got into in my absence?
We are being hailed by an Inquisition ship. We've been asked to heave to, a destroyer specifically. We're trying to determine the best course of action currently.
Their markings? Inquisition?
We know that, yes.
You don't tell me that they're Death Watch or Space Marines?
Not for the moment, no.
Cool. Just
curious. Detail is the name of the ship?
Oh, yeah. So they named the requisite height.
Not a ship I've heard of very well. And what else have they stated?
Simply to heave to, and we're in forbidden Imperial space. So even if we were here with the correct warrant, we're in the wrong place.
And you're confident you can parlay with them?
Not even slightly. The current situation that we're in, not blaming fingers, pointing fingers, the situation that you mostly got us into.
I kind of chuckle a little bit.
Has left us at a disadvantage.
Indeed.
Speaking of which, am I under the understanding that the Soul Gate is still open?
Are you talking out of character?
No, that's me asking, Marius.
You wouldn't know it's called a Soul Gate.
I thought it was mentioned as a Soul Gate by the Eagle during his speech.
The Eagle had the device in his hand, didn't he?
He did. Yeah. I specifically mentioned him calling it a Soul Gate.
Oh, well, my bad then. How the fuck did he know it's called a Soul Gate?
It's a good question.
He's a heretical motherfucker.
Yep.
Not as far as I'm aware.
I think we need to check this first of all.
Well,
of course.
For the moment, I have a few suggestions.
Of course, go ahead.
Well, first of all, it's clear that if we're going to be boarded, that this is not the position for me to be in. I should be on the bridge with the to make contact with the Inquisition.
And we're under the same agreement.
And the who's the head of the Ecclesiarch now on board? Now the Eagle is in chains.
I think he introduced himself. I didn't actually pay attention.
What?
You hear in the background.
And his opinion on the matter?
Misunderstood at best. Seems like he's been out of the loop for a little too long.
Well, it's a high time you have a conversation with him to see where he falls in that loop, Cornelius. Or perhaps I should speak to him directly.
Possibly, yes. Maybe explain your actions.
Very well. Put him on the box, make sure it's a private line.
I thought that was a given, you know me.
I chuckle again.
And I toss the box over to Alaric. There we go.
I drop it. And then I hastily pick it up. Lord Captain, this is Alaric Valerius Apollinaris, at your service.
Ah, the missionary we have aboard, is that right?
That is correct.
Ah. And what is your opinion of these allegations made before me?
I do believe the man that calls himself the Eagle, I do know his name, but I haven't heard it yet. Morgan Gruninger has failed his role as the highest appointed member of the Ecclesiarchy on board of the ship. He let Xenos mislead you and plant devices on you. And has
you don't
swayed...
know that.
Hmm?
You don't know that he has any Xenos devices on his person.
Was it not broadcasted over the whole ship?
Nothing about the Xenos that's inside him. I'm pretty much, me and the Doctor are the only ones that know there's something inside him.
No, I'm talking about Desiree.
He's talking about the Soul Gate they held up. But you don't know that was planted on. I guess you could assume what? That...
If that's the verbiage you want to go with. I just thought you were talking about the information about inside of his body.
Oh, no. I do not know shit about that. I just know that the Dark Elder...
was on the ship. I didn't know about it at the time, but the Eagle did not step in to advise you against taking on such a compatriot.
Indeed I did not, and it was a mistake that I will seek penance for the rest of my days.
The same goes for the crude.
Are you lying, Marius?
No.
But you did enter into an alliance with the Tetrachila.
That's... I see them as a positive force.
But they're still Xenos.
That is true. What was your exact phrasing, Philip?
He said... What was it? Shit.
Because I genuinely am not
he
lying.
He did not advise you against... so you were misled, when you were misled by Xenos, he did not counsel you or advise you.
Ah, yes. So I don't believe that I'm being misled by the Tetrachila. I do believe I was misled by Desarior.
How did he mislead you?
By...
That's fine.
Because of what they have shown me, I have no knowledge, really, of psychic powers in the warp. So from what they have shown me, I have no reason to doubt that, other than the fact that they are Xenos. But I have no reason to doubt their motives. Because I've seen that battle, I've seen the fighting, I took part in that fighting. Whereas I do have a motive for doubting what Desarior did, because I've ended up in this situation. That makes sense.
Sure, if that's what you want to go with.
Yeah, that's totally Desarior's fault.
Okay, Alaric continues his speech and says, I am under the impression that... would I call him Father Gruninger, or what would be the title?
Confessor.
Confessor Gruninger.
He's also has a secondary rank called Arclictor.
That sounds super evil. So, Confessor Arclictor Gruninger used the fact that you have been misled by the Xenos to gain power on his own, to sway the crew, and to imprison you unrightly. Where he did not offer you guidance, he sought to take from you what is rightfully yours. And we shall not have that aboard this ship.
Then it seems we are on the same page, missionary. Now, I am not claiming that I have made bad choices. Far from it. I have made choices that have endangered this crew. Yet, this evidence that he brought towards me is troubling. I spent several days in the underbelly of our ship fighting Xenos. That is a lie, because I don't know what the hell I was doing below ship. I spent several days below deck defending this crew. And I will not have someone claim otherwise or claim falsehoods about me. So I seek your forgiveness.
Are you glossing over the fact that you murdered one of your crew?
I don't mention it.
Okay.
I have said I've made bad choices which have endangered the crew.
You said you made far from bad choices.
Oh no, sorry, I'm far from innocent, but I claim that I do not claim that I have made bad
You haven't made good choices?
Is yes, that what you mean to say? Yes, that's what I mean to say.
Let's say you have made medium choices.
Yeah, medium choices. I'm not saying I'm far from innocent, because I believe I am innocent from heresy. I've just made some bad choices. And I seek your forgiveness and your guidance and counsel in this, missionary.
You sound more and more like an addict to me.
And I will need your counsel moving forward.
As the new head of the missionary, as well as the, would it be ecclesiarchy? On the ship, I shall do my best to protect you from those influences.
Then I implore you to use what knowledge you have to convince the crew of the traitor preacher's true motives, and spirit the ship into more, or lead the ship into a more spiritual conscience.
Out of character, is this possible for a person the crew do not know?
What?
I mean, the crew do not talk to me, right? They always talk to the evil.
Nobody's been talking to you because you kept yourself in isolation, but yeah, otherwise the crew would talk to you.
Okay.
If you allow it.
Of course I do. I mean, this isolation was only going on for the time since the campaign started, not since the ship was in orbit, or the ship was
out. That's fine.
Exploring. So the crew would know me, I would expect. Maybe not Cornelius and the others, but at least Jack should know me. He does know me.
Yeah, Jack probably knows you.
Yeah, so I can speak to the crew, appeal to them to reject the case made against you based on false idolization of a man sought to undermine your authority.
Then I'd ask you to speak with my trusted advisors. Cornelius, the engine seer, Jack, my first officer, and Hayata and the navigator. In addition, there's someone else that you may want to speak with. I've kept his presence secret from the remainder of the crew. He is my officer on board. Wayne. He's known as my Master of Whispers. His identity must remain secret. Yet I will reach out to him and have him make contact with you. He may have further information which can help our cause.
Lord Captain, are you in a position to reach out to him?
Well, you've given me this Foxcaster, have you not?
Yeah, but I understand, Lord Captain.
And I said, I am not one to stray from the Emperor's light. You can trust that in me.
Forgive me, Lord Captain, but I will be the judge of that.
Of course, and you're more than welcome to use whatever blessings the Emperor has given you to search my soul for corruption.
I will.
I ask if you can pass me back to Lord Cornelius.
I shall inquire. Lord Cornelius.
I'm just extending a mechadendrite at this point so they come back off of you.
I throw it over to you.
Yeah, catch it with the mechadendrite.
I see. I'm a bit disappointed that you didn't drop it. Being a prideful man.
I'm proud of other people's failures.
Yes, Captain, it's Lord Cornelius again.
Cornelius, there was troubling footage revealed in that medbay. I would ask if you can...
Say no more.
Very well.
And what of your incarceration? I think the bridge is under the agreement that you should be freed for now.
Yes, I trust that there is a reason you are senior officers on my ship. However, it is not my trusted advisors that I worry about. It is that of the crew and their opinion. Lend what aid you might to the missionary Alaric. His will should sway that of the crew. By that I mean the Emperor's will, and his voice should sway the crew and put them at ease. And once they're appeased, we have a mutineer to execute.
Is that all that we will be executing today?
With the Inquisition bearing down on us, I fear it is not.
Very well.
That's restricted. Restricted on the Lord Captain's orders for now.
I will leave you to your tasks. I'll keep the Vox with me should you wish to ask anything further.
Of course. May I ask how cruel the jailer has been?
Very. The quicker we can put Claudette out of her misery, the better.
Understood.
I would also ask that you... There is I'm looking for the word, Biff. It's not servants, but effectively my, like a butler.
Underling? Don't know.
Like, I can't think of the word of what it would be, but my, like an ensign that looks after my, like doing my laundry and my...
Aid?
Yeah, an aid of mine. There's an aid of mine. Named Wayne. He is on Vox Channel, and I give him the Vox Channel of my Master of Whispers. Ask him to prepare my uniform and bring it down to the brig. I wish to get out of these clothes. Say it is a message from the Lord Captain himself.
Wayne is his name.
Yes.
Of course.
And let Alaric know to speak with him as well if he needs to pass any blessing on to me or words on to me.
Of course. Is there anything that I can have the pilot or the navigator do by chance? I feel that the INS is cagey to say the least.
Make sure nothing goes wrong on the bridge.
So I need to lock Hiata up, do I?
And why is that?
Oh, she has a words, way with words. A terrible way, but definitely a way.
A very decisive way.
We may need her at the helm yet.
That was a jest, Lord Commander.
The last thing we need is Frank behind the wheel. God. No, we may have use of our skill yet. Put her mind at ease, though. I know she's not one of the senior crew, but I do trust her as... I do treat her as a... She is trusted.
I suppose if there is a situation where she can panic, she will do so. For now, I think we're okay.
Indeed.
Isn't she rank 3? Doesn't that count as senior crew?
I mean, yeah. Not as senior as the Master Engineer, Navigator, and First Officer.
She's on the same row as me.
Oh, is she?
Yep.
Fair enough.
Oh, so I've got seniority.
Yeah, you're equal with Jack.
You and Jack are equal.
I only take seniority in, inside the warp.
Yeah, makes sense. Okay, that's a lot to be doing. I'll get to it straight away.
Well, thanks, Cornelius.
Okay, so suppose at that point I disconnect from the throne and go to speak to Alaric.
Yes.
I trust that the captain has given you his orders.
I shall speak to his aide and then address the crew of the ship.
He's also asked that you request Wayne visit him in his cells to outfit him with his proper uniform.
Yes. Shall I do anything else?
For now, I don't see any more use for you. Jack, do you have any suggestions?
No, I don't. Though you should keep an eye on the Eagle. He has significant sway with the crew. If you remove Marius from the break, word will get out.
Well, that is where our newfound friend should perform.
I will. Jack, point me in Wayne's direction. Where can I find it?
I just hand you a data slate with his contact details on that Marius gave me.
I reluctantly take it and make my way to find Wayne.
Don't walk to him, it could take 2 hours.
What? Okay, oh yeah, of course, we're on a ship with telephone. I can contact.
Telephones?
Yes. Give me his number.
Give contact me his details, you've got his number.
Okay, I call him up. Sorry, guys.
Who is this?
This is Missionary Alaric Valerius Apollinaris. You are Wayne, is that correct?
Who gave you these details?
The Lord Captain. He has a message for you. He wishes you to prepare his finest outfit, his finest uniform, and bring it to him into the brig. Also, you are to provide me with all the information I can use to sway the crew against the Eagle in favor of Lord Captain Marius.
Nobody's allowed in the brig.
Not even Jack and Cornelius can...
The first mate and the Lord Engineer have permission to be there, but they must give permission for anybody else.
They will give you permission.
Wait to blow his cover as Master Whispers.
I look up and smile.
What?
Basically saying that either me or Jack need to give you the permission to Wayne to go.
Yeah, so I guess it's nice being the in-between. So I'm still on the bridge, so I say to Jack, please allow Wayne to enter the brig.
Okay, Cornelius. Yeah, Jack does seem confused.
Why would you
ask? As far as he knows, the rogue trader, Lord Marius, has never used an aide, and he certainly doesn't know of an aide named Marius, or Wayne.
Well, I do not know. It's.
But he did hear the Lord Captain specifically ask for him, so he doesn't seem to be questioning it.
Good. The next best thing would be asking a man for an explanation who does not have any answers. So,
if you can give me permission to see the captain, I should get his things prepared.
First, I need you to provide me with the information I need.
On the Eagle?
Yes.
What information do you want?
Is there a catalogue I can choose from? Give me the information.
I don't even know who you are, and you're asking for rather precise things. The Eagle's only recently come out from hiding. I've been doing what I can since then to find information. But he's an elusive figure within the underdecks. What I know so far is he seems to have an illicit goods scheme going on.
I perk up an eyebrow. Is that so?
As far as I can tell, nothing ties to him directly, but to some of his people.
Who are his people?
Why do you want that information?
Because I wish to undermine his claims and free the Lord Captain.
How do you plan to do that?
That is a good question.
If I give you my assets, that will put me in danger, and my own informants in danger.
The Eagle has made some very strong claims against the Lord Captain on his purity and his righteousness. While he himself is not the sparkling light figure in service of the Emperor that he claims to be.
But can you prove otherwise?
That's why I need you.
Yes, and I've been working on him for quite some time, several days now, but I did not know who the Eagle was until he revealed himself. It's only been a day since then. You're asking for miracles. Information takes time.
Can I spend a fate point to make a miracle happen?
You want to spend a fate point to do what?
To make a miracle happen.
What miracle?
Just a little vague.
What?
Just the Lord Emperor himself steps out and claims Maritha's innocence.
Yeah, for example. No, I was joking. That is the talent I have, where I can burn fate points, I think, to save people from certain death. But, I mean, that's another thing entirely. So, all in all, he didn't have enough time to get the information. So
he didn't necessarily say that.
There's just not been enough time since he's gone public.
No. He does not want to, out of character, he does not want to endanger his own position. So he's reluctant to come out.
Yeah.
He does have enough information, yes?
He told you what he told you.
Yeah.
You can make what assumptions you will. Unless you want to make some kind of check.
Yeah, I sure would like to charm this guy into giving me the information. I say, listen to me, Wayne. You are a faithful servant of the Emperor and the Lord Captain of the ship, are you not?
Of course.
And what would you say if another agent of the Emperor and his holiness were to need your help to expose an imposter? Holy Holiness, yes.
I do not work for you. I work for the Lord Captain. And Holiness has nothing to do with that.
Now hold on.
This is the Master of Whispers you're talking about. You can't bullshit a bullshitter.
But
he knows what Marius has and has not done, most likely.
Listen to me. If the Lord Captain gets out of this, you are free to go. You will not be in peril.
I'm not under arrest. I'm telling you, you're endangering my intelligence network.
Philip doesn't
know. I need to know what you plan to do with it before I'm willing to take that risk.
I will expose.
Yes, it's easy to say that you will expose the Eagle, but based on what?
on the information you're giving me. I do not know the information yet.
You yourself have been in isolation since this ship has left the Calixus sector. You have missed many momentous events, and you have not been there for the crew like the Eagle has. His position is solid. What makes you think that they will listen to you?
Get me. I can help. I already spoke to the crew, right?
What?
I'm saying I preached to the crew once already. Maybe they like me a bit more.
Well, I mean, I'm a preacher, man. I want to preach.
There's still hard evidence of what the Lord Captain has done. I've been working towards removing it, but certain individuals have been kept under lock and key.
I understand.
If we can get rid of the evidence, and your securement of my ability to get into the brig will help with this, then we can make a move against the Eagle.
He gives a sigh. Well, I wish we could solve this on a more direct route, but you must speak to the Lord Captain. We will provide you with the allowance to enter the brig and speak to him. Give him his uniform. And in the meantime, I need to get the information how I can possibly sway the crew. Anyway, I have faith in you, son. Yeah, we sure have spent a lot of time debating stuff.
Have they sent us another hail since the first one?
No, they haven't.
They're just plowing towards us.
Quite quickly. Faster than your own ship. By a significant margin. Okay. Well, Wayne cuts off his end of the communication. Make an awareness test.
All of us?
Anybody who wants to, who is on the bridge, let's say that. INSC and Cornelius, you guys have been having this conversation over ship comms. That's not to say that everybody on the ship knows it, but everybody on the bridge in your immediate area has been listening in because you've been doing basically a conference call.
The stuff with the captain was private.
No, it wasn't. I assumed it was, but then multiple people were talking on that line at the same time.
That was the implication I gave when
he explicitly said it was private and then said...
Alex said, is this line private? And I went, you know me. Yeah. That's the implication that we always speak on a private line.
And then when he gave it to...
we changed.
You didn't give it to him. You and Alaric were talking at the same time.
We weren't?
No, I threw the comms device to Alaric.
Okay.
Yes.
That's why there was the joke about the Mechadendrite catching it.
I even rolled agility and failed to catch it.
I missed that. That's my bad, then.
No. So we were speaking separately.
Yeah, I was being very safe to say that this private line, I didn't want the bridge crew knowing about this.
It's just the Sassus Mechanicus. It's like, is this line safe? Sure, whatever.
The only thing they would have heard is when Alaric turned around and asked Jack in front of everyone for Wayne to get permission to go on the brig. They would all have heard that.
Maybe. The bridge is quite large.
Yeah, sure. I just meant that's the only thing that wasn't over a private box.
Yeah.
Everything else was.
Okay, that's my bad. No worries then. Marius, as soon as you cut off the line with the bridge, Fortius takes the Vox and he heads back into his office at the other end of the brig. Claudette is unconscious across the way from you. And you hear from a cell over, which you can't see into, there's a wall separating you. You disappoint me, Maris. You had a chance to cleanse yourself in front of the Emperor. Yet you cling to life and not purity.
Presumably this is the eagle speaking.
Yeah.
I. What fate is to befall me will befall me, because I will not leave my crew stranded in unknown territory.
Unknown territory that you have brought them into, as you have told them to go to. All paths lead to you and your sickly words. You cannot fool me. I know you for what you are. And the Emperor will too. Eventually, you will be judged.
Then I will be judged. My fate is in the Emperor's hands.
Do not speak to me of faith. You do not believe in the Emperor or his glory. You only believe in yourself.
That is where you're mistaken.
Mistaken? Murdering your crew? Yes, you'd care much for them. Mistaken further? Consorting with Xenos' filth?
My actions will be judged by the Emperor and the Ecclesiarchy. You gave up the right to judge
me. The Ecclesiarchy has judged you, but you try to slide your way out of it with your corrupting lies.
You have
judged. You lead your crew into damnation.
You have judged me. Eagle, you gave up your authority when you instigated a mutiny.
Instigated a mutiny, yes. Some will say that. Others will say that I have led this crew back to the path of righteousness. I've done what I can to redeem you, even. You have cast it all aside.
And what have you done to redeem me? Stalk in the shadows? Start mutinies? Start rumors?
Rumors? Rumors of what? What false information have I provided? Yes, I thought as much. Talk to me not. I heed not your corrupting words of chaos that you sow.
Use what powers the Emperor have given you to search me for corruption, and you will find none.
I find that unlikely.
Then
I will not sully myself with further conversation with you.
Then summon for the Navigator. She has the power to seek out to view corruption in a person's soul. As I said, you will find none.
You don't hear anything back from him. You just hear the light sounds of prayer.
Okay.
Cornelius, you take Ionesi aside.
Ionesi.
Hello.
Hello. Ionesi, the Lord Captain has some orders of us that he wishes to for us to take out.
Oh yeah, like it. side a little bit closer.
I'm assuming that you spotted the footage the eagle showed during his speech.
Yes, of course. We were there at watching it over the crew shoulders.
I should be able to purge the data from the ship's systems. However, we need to make sure that personal possession of the data is eliminated.
I have no skill in technocratic mumbo-jumbo. Technical mumbo-jumbo.
There's only so much I can do as one person. I just wish for your help.
Oh, I do, that's a lie. Okay. Yes, yes, I can aid you. You're much more skilled than me than in the technical side, but I'll do what little I can. I desperately think that we need to be in a very strong position by the time that and I'll look out over the view into space before they reach us.
That time that we're rapidly running out of, yes. As I say, I'm only one person. I need your help.
I will assist you however I can in this matter, Cornelius. Anything we can do to make our ship a more amicable place for the Inquisition. And less likely to end with us all burning in a fire.
And I understand your hesitation to try and deal with this matter that you deem my own. However, the Soulgate is another matter of concern.
No, yes, you're correct. It is the duty of all of us, as members of the Bridge, to remove the heresy. And the Xenos tech is included in that. I don't know what the Lord Captain was doing, mucking around with Xenotech, but we should destroy it as soon as possible.
Which I think should be done before our friends in the Inquisition.
Agreed. I worry that the Eagle might inform them of it, though, and they... Unless you can cleanse all the picked recordings if they find out we've been destroying... Well, I guess we can say we're destroying Xenos tech because of Xenos tech. Not destroying evidence. We would never do such a thing.
I think we have to tread a very thin line to avoid incrimination no matter what we do.
I'll be honest with you, Cornelius. The Inquisition and my house, we do not have a positive relationship.
This will be a matter that we need to discuss in the future. For now, we need to get to the task at hand. I will seek your counsel later.
Okay. I'll cleanse all the picked recordings I can. Time to go type really fast on my keyboard!
Yeah, so I would be hooking into the main ship system to try and cleanse everything of that recording that I can find.
Okay. We'll come back to that after a break. Let's go ahead and meet up at 5 after.
Thank you very much, guys, for watching Veil of Sanity Part 1. Join us after the break. Bye.
INSE, I want you to think about why Space Marines don't like your house.
Okay. Bye.